Hello, dear friends. You are welcome to our English lesson. Module, our neighborhood. The theme of our lesson is our neighborhood. Today, we are working at these learning objectives. By the end of the lesson, you will have practiced your listening skills by listening to sentences about neighborhood. Practiced asking and giving directions with the words on the topic. You've been engaged in a role-playing activity. Let's start. Look at the picture. What is it? It's a neighborhood. Neighborhood is an area where people live and interact with one another. Neighborhood is defined as a group of houses or buildings that are together in an area that are grouped together as a unit. So, let's learn new words. Listen, repeat, and read. Places in the neighborhood. Bakery. Post office. Chemists. Bank. Music shop, clothes shop, jewelers, supermarket, florists, sports shop, opticians, bookshop, newsagent, now read and repeat all the new words after me. Neighborhood, bakery, post office, chemists, bank, music shop, clothes shop, jewelers, supermarket, florists, sports shop, opticians, bookshop, news agents. Very well, boys and girls. Now, stop the video, open your vocabulary, write them down in your copybook, learn them by heart. I think it's time to play with words. Look at these pictures and find out their names and complete the crosswords. What shop is number one? What shop is the second one? Think and fill in. You may stop the video for a minute. Okay, I am sure that you have guessed all the words and gave correct answers. Nevertheless, check yourself. You know all the new words, but why not to use them? So let's make sentences. You can buy bread at a bakery. You can buy stamps at a post office. You can buy aspirin at a chemist's. You can buy foreign currency at a bank. Now it's your turn. Try to complete the sentences and write them down in your copybooks. You can buy musical instrument at a. You can buy trousers at a. You can buy a gold ring ate. You can buy at a florist's. You can buy sport boots at a. You can buy what you can buy at a. Now you may check yourself. Check yourself looking at these sentences and write them down in your copybooks. Okay, look at these objects, students. What are they? Yes, a ball and a red cube. So, using the objects, we can revise prepositions of place. Where is the cube? It is next to the ball. Where is the cube? It is near the ball. Where is the cube? It is behind the ball. Where is the cube? It's in front of the ball. Where is the cube? It's between two balls. Where is the ball? Where is the cube? It is above ball. Where is the cube? It is opposite the ball. If we renew our knowledge, it's time to practice. Use these prepositions to ask for and give directions as an example. Excuse me, where is the bakery? It's on Apple Street, next to the chemist's. Where is the? Excuse me, where is the post office? It's on Milton Street, behind the bank. Excuse me, where is the sports shop? It's on Apple Street. The florist and optician. So the answer is between the florist and optician. Excuse me, where is the bookshop? It's on Apple Street. The newsagent. Next to the newsagent. Now let's sum up. Today you have learned a lot of information about neighborhood. Look at the questions and try to answer them correctly. If you answer correctly, you can get a star. So read and think. Answer the questions. What is the neighborhood? Can you call 10 names of places in your neighborhood? Can you talk about shops and markets? Can you name more than 6 prepositions of direction? Can you ask for and give directions? If you get 5 stars, excellent. If you get 4 stars, good. If you get 3 stars, try again. I hope all of you have 5 stars. If you had less, watch the video again. Learn words. Only hard work will bring you success. That's all, boys and girls. Thank you. Goodbye.